Hits from 1981 to 85, so it's got the songs on there: Crazy Doctor, Run for Your Life, I know that one, Crazy Night. It's got a really good guitar intro. So yeah, this must be like their early hits that were re-released as a greatest hits package. On the internet it's classed as a box set. Apparently, I read on the internet, this isn't a very well-liked album by Bow Wow fans. One guy says on the internet, "Warning from Stardust," so that's the name of the album. It's an alright album, but if you want to get into this great Japanese rock band, seek out their earlier work. This album was more of a commercial direction. It's not as heavy or creative as their earlier albums. I mean, you know, 2020, it sounds pretty good, but I guess, you know, at the time it was sort of a little bit more poppy. Amazing, you know, like they didn't want you to copy music back then, but they're advertising blank cassettes on the back. This one's called It's All in the Movies. It came out 1976. It's his 19th album. He sometimes bought out a couple of albums a year. Yeah, he's really amazing sort of musician. The album's title track became Haggard's 8th consecutive number one. It's got a couple of big songs on there: Games People Play and Time. Cafes love this kind of music. It's very sort of middle of the road kind of music. You go into a cafe, not Starbucks, but the older cafes, you'll often hear Time and Games People Play just on the reel playing. He toured with Aerosmith as a support and Lynyrd Skynyrd. Toured with Neil Young as well. Yeah, he's very busy through the 70s and 80s, and then, you know, into the 90s, he recorded a few albums that more into the blues territory. The synth pop group NASA was on the verge of reaching an American audience when the rug was suddenly pulled from under them. In 1985, they released their first single, Paula. Yeah, it's pretty intense. Heavy even. Yeah, their first single was Paula, top 10 success in Sweden. 1987, they went to America to record an album, possibly this one, but then there was a space shuttle disaster. Yeah, because of that space shuttle Challenger disaster, the record company didn't want to market them. Just reading on the back cover, this live performance was a benefit free store food bank. So it was actually a charity concert. Ray's crying. I don't know who originally done it. Yeah, it's got some great songs on there if you like George Thorogood, you know, One Bourbon, One Scotch, One Beer. I Drink Alone, that's a great song, classic. It's his third solo album. It came out 1982. And Bill Kerbishley was connected to the album somehow. So he had a Judas Priest connection, by memory. This album taunted the cynics and critics at the time. Deliverance is the third album and the first live album by American country rock band Poco. Jim Messina quit the band in October 1970 prior to the release of the album. So I guess Messina actually sung on this album. But by the time it came out, Timothy B. Schmidt was the lead singer. But he's actually just playing bass. Doesn't really sort of sound like Eagles. I don't know what it is about it. It's probably the back vocals. Eagles are a little bit sort of more harmonized, I guess. And I'll catch you later.